All right, so why don't we start with Herb, obviously. Urban Meyer made his much-anticipated appearance before the media yesterday, and he came strong, and he made a powerful statement. I mean, that really is hilarious, because anybody anywhere gives a damn about any of that. No one is here for that. No one gives a damn about anything you have to say about the AFC South or putting on the videotape of week one versus week four. The only video that people were talking about were the videos that were shot in Columbus last week and then surfaced online over the weekend. That's all that matters right now. That's all that matters with you, Herb, right now. Not that you know or care. So why don't we just get into this thing? Why don't we talk about what really matters here? The Jags lose to Cincinnati on Thursday night. They fall to 0-4. Standard operating procedure at that point is the team flies back home. The players get some extra time off. The coaches use that extra time to grind tape and get ready for the next game, especially if you're 0-4 and arguably the worst team in the world and nothing is going right. That's SOP for any NFL head coach who's got half a brain. But of course, that's not what Herb did. Herb did not do that. Do you remember his act after that loss to Cincinnati? Remember how he was talking about how that loss was, quote, devastating? You remember? And never mind that his body language was terrible and his talking points were even worse and he's showing himself to be incapable of leading or motivating or inspiring anybody on this level. Bad enough that he actually said those things or used those words. Even worse, though, to see what he actually did about said devastation and heartbreak. Or in this case, what he did not do. He didn't get on a plane. He didn't get his ass back to work. He skipped the plane and stayed in Ohio so he could, in his words, stay and hang out with his grandchildren. You know, forget for a moment that those videos sure did not look like grandpa hanging with grandkids. A head coach staying behind to hang out with his family simply does not happen. It just doesn't. Further evidence that this guy just doesn't have it. He doesn't get it. He's not built for it. When I say that it's standard operating procedure that the coach flies home with the team, it's the only operating procedure. Michelle Steele tweeted, quote, "We have tried to come up with another example of a coach not traveling back home with the team, and it's virtually unheard of. Parcells did not fly back with the Patriots after the loss to Green Bay in the Super Bowl in 97. He would not coach another game for New England." Lindsey Jones tweeted, quote, "The Jags fired Gus Bradley in Houston in late 2016, and he still flew back on the team plane," end quote. So that's how freaking unreal the initial decision was before we even get to those embarrassing videos. He already made another terrible decision. Another terrible decision in a series of terrible decisions since arriving in Jacksonville in the first place. Like, you know, yeah, you guys take that L. You guys go on back to Jacksonville. I'm going to stay in Ohio and hang out with my fam. No, I'm not going to travel with my team to hammer away and fix this problem. Nope, I'm just going to kick it with the fam instead. I mean, could this dude be any more clueless about how things are done in the NFL than he is? That just does not happen. Now, you might think that it's kind of sweet that the old man wanted to get in some in-person time with the grandkids, but again, it doesn't happen, at least not like this and not during an NFL season. Is Urban Meyer the first NFL head coach with family? Hell no. Is he the first one who would love to get a little extra time in with his family? Of course not. But he apparently is the first one to bail on his team after a road loss like that in order to spend time with his family. I mean, credit to this dude. This is what he said that he would do when he quit on Florida. Remember? He needed more family time. It's just weird that it took him all this time and took him this long to get around to spending time with the family. So, Then, according to Herb, he throws on the Ohio State pullover, and we could spend another hour unpacking the psychological implications of a guy who's bombing out in the NFL, wanting to reclaim his glory days from his last good job. But he throws on the Ohio State shirt, and he goes to a restaurant bearing his name. A sad and pathetic attempt to get some love and positive vibes from a place where he actually mattered. You know the saying, always forward, never back? Not with this dude. He couldn't wait to go back. You know, like that loser who graduates high school and then shows up again on campus a few years later knowing that his life will never be better than it was back then. You see, the problem with that is, the problem isn't with the fact that it's an absurd description of what happened. But we've all seen the video. So get out of here with that bullcrap, Herb. Oh, and then there's this. There's a second video, a second angle, a second shooter on the grassy knoll. Let me read you the description from ESPN. Quote, roughly an hour after Meyer's news conference Monday, another video emerged on social media that appeared to show Meyer touching a woman's bottom while he was sitting at the bar. The woman appeared to be wearing the same clothes, jeans, and a white top as the woman in the first viral video. End of quote. You know things are bad when ESPN's got to write that the video, quote, appeared to show Meyer touching a woman's bottom. Having seen the alleged second video, sure as hell didn't look to me like he was being dragged out onto a dance floor. Not at all. Not at all. I mean, how insanely delusional and arrogant and ignorant and out of touch do you have to be to think that you could just bluff and lie your way out of this? Did you really think that there would not be another video in this day and age? Did you really think that nobody was going to notice that you put on an Ohio State pullover and went to a restaurant with your name on it to get noticed? And that's what you do. According to reports, Trevor Lawrence went to Las Vegas in March in the middle of the offseason before he was even drafted. Man, there is such an enormous difference between going to Las Vegas in the offseason before you're drafted and, quote, touching a woman's bottom on video after a week four loss. Number two, Trevor Lawrence's bachelor party was described by TMZ as, quote, low-key. Number three, keep Trevor Lawrence's name out your mouth. This is not about Trevor Lawrence.
Keep my name
it's
out
about
your
you,
mouth.
Herb. And if I were Trevor Lawrence, man, I'd be pissed. I'd be pissed that you're comparing the two incidents because they're nothing alike. Pretty remarkable for a guy whose mantra for the team has been own it. Own it. That's the motto. Own it. Pretty rich to bring up his quarterback's off-season trip that did not produce any videos like this. How pissed would you be if you're Lawrence? And how little do you think that every single guy in that locker room must think of Herb for name-checking the most important person in the organization in order to cover his own ass when that person had absolutely nothing to do with the horrible decision-making that the old man himself made? And this guy is the one saying that the team motto is own it. What a freaking hypocrite. That's funny. It really is funny. Back when Meyer hired Chris Doyle, the strength coach, in the racial discrimination lawsuit, and then Doyle resigned because everybody said that was a horrible idea. Everybody not named Herb, that is. Back then, Meyer said, quote, we don't need a distraction. Moving forward is the best interest of all. End quote. Again, hilarious. Because all this guy has done is be a distraction since he got there. Hiring Doyle for a few minutes, bringing in Tim Tebow, getting fined 300 grr for rules violations, that idiotic quarterback competition that nobody believed in the first place, and now this. And why? Because hashtag buddy deserved a night out. Every coach in the history of football on every level ever tells his team, don't be a distraction, including Herb. yet he himself is one of the biggest distractions ever. Again, a complete and total hypocrite. The only guy who believes Urban Meyer's BS is Urban Meyer, and that's always been the case. Because everywhere he's been, he has stood up at a microphone and lectured everybody on morals and how to live. And he's been so full of it every time. Now, I'm not saying the Jags will fire him for this, but I could see where they might want to, because this is not what they're paying him to do. I mean, they should have known what they were getting when they hired this guy. But I'm sure Shad Khan didn't think, hey man, why don't we pay this guy Crazy Jack, let him come in, lose every single game, create distractions all the time, and then get nice and go viral for grinding with young women. Again, I'm not saying that they will fire him, but I can completely understand why they might want to. And there is that one report that the organization has considered it. And by the way, importantly, exactly how does this guy go back into his locker room and try to lead now? How does this guy have any credibility whatsoever with his players and coaches on anything now? Forget the videos. The head coach of an 0-4 team decided Buddy deserved a night out instead of going back to work and fixing it. They're 0-4, their worst record through four games since 2014. And for a team that's had some really bad years, that's their worst start in a long time. They're the only team in the league that hasn't scored more than 21 points this season. So maybe instead of touching a woman's bottom, hanging out with your grandkids, you go grind some tape instead of letting co-eds grind on you. And you scheme your way to a few touchdowns instead of hanging out with co-eds at your own restaurant who have never heard of you and want you to stop creeping on them. How about you do that? How about you do what you always do when things get tough and adversity hits? You just quit. Because this could not be going any worse than it is right now, and it's all your own doing, Gramps. So, in your own words, own it. Like, I knew this could go badly. I never could have ever imagined it being the disaster it is already. Already you've got the owner issuing statements four games in about where they're at. And a report that they're looking at whether or not there's a morals clause that they can use to get away from this guy. And good luck getting anybody. Good luck coaching these guys up now. And believe me, they can see through all that college bullcrap. And they can see through all the hypocrisy. And he already had issues in that locker room even before. I'm not even there and I know that. He already had issues in that locker room even before he came off the rails.